This is our recommended technique to prepare MaxCell for pulling into your conduit structure. First, cut a 2 to 3 inch slit just below the sewn seam, 12 to 18 inches from the end. Next, pull out 12 to 18 inches of the pull tapes from the end of the MaxCell through the slit and cut them off. This will allow the pull tapes to float behind your pulling grip when pulling in MaxCell. Now that your pull tapes are cut back, this is how to make a MaxCell pulling harness with scrap pull tape or rope. First, tie the rope or tape to the slit area. Then make 4 to 5 half hitches to form your grip on the end of MaxCell. Once you get to the end, tape the header using vinyl electrical tape. Make sure the pull tapes are free-floating behind the grip. The most important tool to make your MaxCell installation a success is a ball bearing swivel. A ball bearing swivel must always be used between the pull tape or rope and MaxCell. This keeps the MaxCell from twisting. Using a bowline knot, attach the existing pull tape from the rigid conduit to the other end of the swivel. Remember to tape all knots. When pulling in MaxCell, designers should make every effort to conform to industry standards with regard to distances between any two pull points, number of bends between any two pull points, and proofing of conduit pathway using appropriately sized mandrels. Here, the pull tape is being mechanically pulled by the pulling machine or tugger. If you are not ready to pull cable after installing MaxCell, you can do some housekeeping to keep your extra lengths of MaxCell from hanging freely in your maintenance hole. Pull the MaxCell up, fold it back, and tie wrap it close to the conduit opening. This will keep it from getting muddy or stepped on. When you are ready to pull cable, you'll need to tie off your MaxCell on the end your cable will be entering. This will prevent any possible MaxCell movement during the cable pull. This can be done by putting a 1-inch slit in your MaxCell edge just inside the color thread seam, 12 to 18 inches from the end. Then, take a rope or pull tape and tie off the MaxCell to something convenient, which can be permanent or temporary. When installing your first cable into MaxCell, we suggest using the center cell. Install additional cables in either cell next to the center cell. Repeat this procedure when multiple MaxCell packs are installed. We suggest in all pulls, even though MaxCell is pre-lubricated, to apply lubricant to your cable. It will always help ensure that your cable will pull more easily. All lubricants need to be cable pulling type lubricants. Never use organic based greases or oils. Silicone type cable lubricants are recommended.